Thanks for joining us at 6. New numbers tonight show Minnesota's four-year graduation rate is dropping. According to the state's Department of Education, just over 83% of high schoolers got their diploma last year, down 0.3% from 2022. Now, while that decrease may not seem like much, the impact is widespread.
Kaya Edwards shares what might be behind the drop and how education leaders are trying to prevent it from getting worse.
Well, we looked into the biggest districts in the metro. While Minneapolis and St. Paul public schools had fewer students graduating in 2023 than 2022, Anoka-Hennepin schools outperformed the state average.
For the class of 2023, high school was not normal. The COVID-19 pandemic started when they were just freshmen, and yet Minnesota's largest district saw a rise in graduates.
We worked real hard and made additional investments in academic support and mental health support.
Corey McIntyre is superintendent of Anoka-Hennepin Schools, where the graduation rate rose 0.7% from 2022, the second highest hike in district history.
We know that ninth graders need to do really well, and that's a strong predictor of graduation in the future. So making sure that there were strong connections to the adults, to each other.
The numbers come from a new Minnesota Department of Education report, which shows the four-year graduation rate dipped slightly statewide, with about 83% of seniors getting a diploma last year. Whereas in Anoka-Hennepin, almost 87% walked the stage, a difference of 3.4%.
All school districts are working real hard like we are to close those achievement gaps.
This is now the third consecutive year rates dropped in St. Paul public schools, this time about 73% graduating if you include summer graduates. The district says solutions include increasing access to internships and bringing real-world experiences into the classroom. Meanwhile, Minneapolis also dropped after improving in 2022. Both districts point to the pandemic and shifts to distance learning.
All school districts did get an infusion of federal dollars to add those supports, and this is the last year of those dollars and those resources. And working with our legislature, working with our local communities on how do we continue to prioritize the kind of supports we need.
The state report shows fewer Black, Asian, Latino, and English learner students graduating. Anoka-Hennepin, though, had at least two student groups of color graduate at rates at or above 90% of all of its traditional high schools.